Now, sa next problem naman, moment tayo dito, and then, pag dito ako, masasali yung A sa ka C. Pag dito, masasali yung A sa ka B. Nako, sa problem na to, we need 3 equations talaga. Kasi tatlong tension forces kasi. And isa dito, and another one here. So sabihin natin, this is TA. Ito naman, TB. And then, TC. Yan. So we can choose an axis kung saan tayo mag-moment. So ideally, mag-moment tayo kung saan may force na ma-eliminate. So saan ba? First, dito tayo sa x-axis mag-moment. Pag sa x-axis ka mag-moment, wala nang moment yung TA. Kasi hindi na siya kasala. Yung line of action kasi niya tatama sa x-axis. So masasali na lang TC saka TB. And then meron din pala tayong masses. Mass 2 weighs 200 kilograms. Yan. And then mass 1 is 300, 100, 200 ito naman 300. And then mass 3 is 200 kilograms. Yan. And then, yung platform, meron din siyang mass na 500 kilograms. So, yan. 500. Now, in newtons yung kailangan natin. So, gagawin ko is I will just convert it later and then let's just solve using itong naka-kilograms lang para wala nang decimals. Yan. So, first, we can take moments about the x-axis. Yan. So, lahat ng distances natin must be perpendicular to the x-axis. So, first, we have TB. Ito. TB multiplied by 1. Yan. So, gagawin ko na lang, diba, yung moment na makukause ng tension forces ko are all counterclockwise about the x-axis. So, equate ko na lang yung counterclockwise moments sa clockwise moments. So, yung TB, it has a moment arm of 1 meter going to the x-axis. So, TB multiplied by 1. And then, itong TC naman, it has a moment arm of 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, 4 meters going to the x-axis. Yung distance na yan, 4. So, plus TC multiplied by 4. Yan na yung lahat ng counterclockwise moments natin. Now, how about for the clockwise moments? Equate natin siya sa... let's first look at this force. So 100 kilograms multiplied by 1 meter going to the x-axis. So 100 times 1. And then 300 kilograms, the same lang yata yung center of gravity niya, andito rin. So 1 meter siya patungo sa x-axis. So plus 300 multiplied by 1. And then itong 500 kilograms nasa gitna, so it has a moment arm of 1 plus 1, 2 meters going to the x-axis. So 500 multiplied by 2. And then itong 200 kilograms, it has a moment arm of 1 plus 1 plus another 1. So 3 meters, yan, patungo sa x-axis. So plus 200 multiplied by 3. Yan. So this is now my first equation. And then we can reduce this. Gawin na lang natin TB. Parang TB plus 4TC equals, sum up natin yan lahat, 100 plus 300 plus 500 times 2, 1000 plus 600. So 2000. Again, naka-kilograms pa yan lahat. Let's just convert that later. So this is my first equation muna. And then, my second equation is, saan ba tayo pwede mag-moment so that we can eliminate a force? Dito na lang, sa y-axis na lang. Hindi pa rin masasali yung TA. Yan. So sum up tayo ng moments about the y-axis equals 0. And then let's just equate again lahat ng counterclockwise moments sa, I mean, yes, lahat ng counterclockwise moments, equate natin sa lahat ng clockwise moments. So yung forces natin na tensile forces, magkukos sila ng clockwise rotation about the y-axis. So, i-separate natin sila. And then, itong masses natin, still, opposite yung direction nila, direction ng rotation sa tensile forces. So, we have TB. I-arrange natin according to this. Yan. TB multiplied by 3 meters. Yang distance niyan going to the y-axis. And then plus TC, ito multiplied by 1 meter, still going to the y-axis. So equal yan to, sum up natin yung forces na yan. So 100 kilograms, it has a moment arm of 1 plus 1, 2, going to the y-axis. And then yung 300 naman, meron siyang moment arm na 1 meter going to the y-axis. So, plus 300 times 1. And then yung 500, moment arm niya is nasa gitna yan, be careful. So 1 plus 1 plus 1, 3. Half of that is 1.5. Ibig sabihin, ito pala, yung distance niya yan is 1.5 meters. Yan, wala kasi yan siya sa line. So nasa gitna yan. So plus 500 multiplied by 1.5. Tapos na to, ito rin. And then yung 200 kilograms, 1 meter yung distance niya patungo sa y. So, plus 200 times 1. So, we can reduce this equation into this one. Saan ba yung, ito pala. Yan. Sum up natin to, 200 plus 300 plus 500 times 1.5 plus 200. So, 1,450. So, 3TB pala, 3TB plus TC equals 1,450. Again, ito yung first equation natin. Ito yung second equation. And then, my third equation, for the third equation, we can sum up moments, or para mas madali, let's just sum up forces vertical na lang. Yan. So, we have TA plus TB plus TC equal yan sa lahat ng downward forces. So, 100 plus 300 plus 500 plus 200. So, ano yung value na yan? Ano na lang? 400, 900, 200, 1,100. So, copy na lang natin. Yan. Gawin natin 1,100. Yan. So, ito na yung third equation natin. So, gagamitan na lang natin ng calculator technique. So, press mode, then equation, then three unknowns. Yan, press 2. So, for the first equation, walang, let's just read TA as X, ito naman Y, ito naman Z. So, the first equation doesn't contain a term na merong TA, so 0 yung coefficient niya. And then, yung TB naman is 1. And TC is 4. Yan. And then, yung constant term sa kabilang side ng equation is 2,000. Yan. And then, for the second equation, we have 3 for TB. So, dito. And then, this is 1. Equal to 1,450. Yan. And then, for the last one, 1 lahat ng coefficients. So, 1, 1, and another 1 equal to 1,100. So, press equals, ito na yung tension at A. In kilograms pa to. So, TA is 340.91 kilograms. We have to multiply this by 9.81 para maging newtons. TB naman is 345.45 and TC is 413.64. Yan. So, times 9.81 lahat. So, check natin. And then, ito naman, by the way, 340.91 pala. Sorry, sorry. Yan, 3344 pala, 0.32. And then, the second one is 345.45. So, 3388.86. And then, ito naman, 413.64 times 9.81. So, 4,057.8. Yan. So, check natin yung questions. Determine the tension of the cable at C. So, yan yung TC. So, 4057.8. We have letter... ito, letter C. Approximately. And then, determine the tension of the cable at A. Ito yan, TA. So, 3344. Ito, yan, letter A. Yung 3390, that's for the tension at B. So, be careful lang din sa choices. Baka sa time nyo, yung tanong na is ano yung tension at B. So, ito na yung sagot mo. But be careful lang kasi magbabago kasi yung masses din. Nakaprogram kasi yung quizzes.